Right, and next, back to the good old adage that indeed to have your content amplified, it better be good content. But our take here is slightly different. Paolo is going to talk about how indeed you should talk to your consumers, to people, rather than talk to you, agencies present here. Paolo, over to you.
Hello, everybody. I didn't bring any figures or any numbers for you, but I'd like to share with you an idea and a concept. Our world is changing very fast, faster than ever. I like to say when I go to bed, I feel very well informed and very well updated. But when I wake up in the next morning, I feel myself completely out of the market because so many things had happened during the night and I'm completely out of the market. The digital is our biggest transformation in our industry. Fastest, powerful, the biggest. And we start to use the display media. Banners, pop-ups were very fresh and new, but soon we will start to use videos. The TV commercials, the commercial done from TV, now we're on the net. And suddenly, we start to develop content, specific content for this new world. And here, we had a very, very important boom. We start to share everything. We start to share from the pets or babies videos to cars or banks commercial. We start everything to everywhere. And the social media became a huge, important communication tool for us. But probably you know everything about social media. We have very, very brilliant guys here. But I'd like to ask you a question. Are we talking about consumers, clients, or people? In my opinion, it's a very simple question, but with a complex answer, a very important answer. Why? Because we are consumers, we are clients, but above all, we are people. And I can't believe that anybody can wake up in the morning and think, oh, today I will be the best consumer in town. Probably everybody can wake up in the morning and think, oh, today I will change the world, today I will be a better person, but not I want to be the consumer number one. Then, if I am right, consumers have wallets, but people have hearts. And I can't believe anymore in share of pockets or share of wallets. I can believe in share of hearts. We need to involve people with our brand. We need to engage. We need to create an emotional relationship with people. Because relationships are long-lasting, and they have the power to change the consumer into brand fans. And here, I'm not saying a lot fans or likes, about fans, real fans. Fans have passion and fans care. To turn commercial content into emotional content is a small step with a great meaning. And social media is here to allow us to do this like never before. And how can we work on it? I believe that we must get the brain to the heart. To motivate somebody to choose for a brand or a product can be much more an emotional decision than a rational decision. Let me show you two cases that we've been working at Tallinn in São Paulo for two clients, Mizuno and Santander. Mizuno is a well-known brand, is trying to survive in a very competitive market in Brazil against ASICS, Adidas, Nike. And Mizuno is a well-known brand for the professionals. But we need to be, Mizuno be very well-known for the street runners, like me in the past, not today. Then we develop a specific run for Mizuno, the first uphill marathon in Brazil. And through the social media, we invited runners to sign up this event. But we chose only 50 lucky fans. Let me show you a video, please.
uma maratona no lugar perfeito, que era aqui na Serra do Rio do Rastro, e num formato inovador, que era subida. Cada um tem o seu limite. Você só sabe o seu limite quando você ultrapassa ele. Ele está te dando até uma chance de saber que o seu limite é um pouquinho mais do que você imagina. Uma família, ela se fortalece nos momentos difíceis. Né? E aqui não deixa de ser uma família, onde você está ali fraco e um amigo seu um pouco mais forte, e vocês vão se ajudar.
Nós vamos chegar juntos.
Aqui é parceria, brother.
Aqui, um empurra o outro empurra um. Vamos chegar juntos e vamos chegar bem lá em cima. É isso aí.
Essa aqui é a terra do Rio do Rastro, onde os corredores ficam humildes. Aqui não tem valente.
Se eu concluir uma prova como essa, eu tenho que concluir outras coisas na minha vida. A grande missão que eu sinto é isso. Eu vou levar muito da opinião para a minha vida.
The second one is Santander. Clients and banks in Brazil are not a very peaceful relationship. Clients are always complaining through the social media against taxes, products, prices, and we need to change this trend. The World Cup was arriving in Brazil, and Neymar was sponsored by the Santander. I don't think about the World Cup anymore, but the World Cup was arriving. Then you ask for people to, or the fans to send very support messages to Neymar before the World Cup. Let me show you a video again.
Mi nombre es Ryan. Me gusta jugar al fútbol porque meto goles, lo celebro.
Tive a oportunidade de ver o Rei Pelé mostrar para o mundo o que é o futebol brasileiro. Estou muito feliz com a oportunidade de poder dizer para o Neymar.
Neymar é delantero como eu, e eu de maior quero ser como ele. Já?
Neymar.
Olha, Neymar.
Neymar, é um prazer falar com você.
Quero ver você brilhando.
Muita sorte no seu caminho.
Quero te desejar toda a sorte do mundo.
É o maior representante do futebol arte hoje do Brasil.
Inspira meninos a seguirem com sonhos.
Me chamo Ryan, tenho 6 anos e não posso, papá.
Por que não pode?
Que dá vergonha.
E agora?
Agora
não. Neymar, bola pra frente.
Olha. Oh, não!
Tá.
We didn't win, but we had a lot of success with this. This video got more than 50 million views in Brazil. These are real examples that we've been doing in Brazil based on this concept. And I believe that the future is open. We can build this future together. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Obrigado.
Obrigado.